ஜீவன்முக்திப்ரதம் தேவம் க்ஷமாபூர்ணம் ஜகத்குரும் வந்தே பரமஹம் சாக்யம் நித்யானந்தாய ஸ்வாகதம். ஜீவன்முக்திப்ரதம் தேவம் க்ஷமாபூர்ணம் ஜகத்குரும் வந்தே பரமஹம் சாக்யம் நித்யானந்தாய ஸ்வாகதம். ஆனந்தானுபவாஸ்வாதம் சர்வரோகநிவாரகம் வந்தே பாப விநாசக்தம் நித்யானந்தாய ஸ்வாகதம். ஆனந்தானுபவாஸ்வாதம் சர்வரோகநிவாரகம் வந்தே பாப விநாசக்தம் நித்யானந்தாய ஸ்வாகதம். நித்யமுக்தம் நிர்விகல்பம் தியானலோக பிரதீபகம்.
பரமஹம்ச நித்யானந்தரு நம்ம யுகத ஒப்ப அபூதபூர்வ ஆத்யாத்மிக சக்தி, ಅಂತಾರಾಷ್ಟ್ರೀಯ ಆಧ್ಯಾತ್ಮಿಕ ಸಮಾಜದ ಆಂದೋಲನದ ಸಂಸ್ಥಾಪಕರು, ಆಧುನಿಕ ವೈದಿಕ ನವೋದಯದ ಪ್ರಥಮ ಅನ್ವೇಷಕ, ಪವಿತ್ರ ಊರಾದ ತಿರುವಣ್ಣಾಮಲೈನಲ್ಲಿ ಜನ್ಮ ತಾಳಿದ ಒಬ್ಬ ಯೋಗಿ, ಕೆಚ್ಚೆದೆಯ ಆಧ್ಯಾತ್ಮಿಕ ಸಂಶೋಧಕ, ದೈವ ಶಕ್ತಿಯ ಮಾರ್ಗದರ್ಶಕ ಜ್ಯೋತಿ ಪರಮಹಂಸ ನಿತ್ಯಾನಂದರು ಇಂದು ಪ್ರಾಚೀನ ರಹಸ್ಯಾರ್ಥ ಯೋಗ ವಿಜ್ಞಾನದ ಪಥದಲ್ಲಿರುವ ಲಕ್ಷಾಂತರ ನಿಪುಣರಿಗೆ ಸ್ಫೂರ್ತಿದಾಯಕರಾಗಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಆಧ್ಯಾತ್ಮಿಕತೆಯ ವಿಜ್ಞಾನದ ಸಂಶೋಧನಾಕಾರ, ಆತ್ಮ ಸಾಕ್ಷಾತ್ಕಾರ ತೋರುವ ಗುರುಗಳು, ಅವರ ವಿವೇಕದ ಸಂಪತ್ತು, ಅವರ ನಗುವಿನ ಆ ಸಂತಸ ಹಾಗೂ ಅವರ ಅದ್ವಿತೀಯ ದೀಕ್ಷೆಯ ಶಕ್ತಿಯನ್ನು ಪ್ರತಿ ವರ್ಷ ಪರಮಹಂಸ ನಿತ್ಯಾನಂದರು ಪ್ರಪಂಚದಾದ್ಯಂತ ಸುಮಾರು 1 ಕೋಟಿ ಜನರೊಡನೆ ಹಂಚಿಕೊಳ್ಳುತ್ತಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಈಗ ಪರಮಹಂಸ ನಿತ್ಯಾನಂದರು ಜೀವನ್ಮುಕ್ತಿಯ ಬಗ್ಗೆ, ಆನಂದಮಯ ಜೀವನಕ್ಕಾಗಿ ಪರಿಹಾರಗಳ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಮಾತನಾಡಲಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಮರೆಯಲಾರದ ಆಧ್ಯಾತ್ಮಿಕ ಅನುಭವವನ್ನು ಕೈಗೊಳ್ಳೋಣ, ಬನ್ನಿ.
ಸ್ವಾಗತಂ ಸರ್ವ ಧರ್ಮ ಪ್ರಣೇತಾರಂ ಸಚ್ಚಿದಾನಂದ ರೂಪಿಣಂ ವಂದೇ ಸನಾತನಂ ಪುಣ್ಯಂ ನಿತ್ಯಾನಂದಾಯ ಸ್ವಾಗತಂ ವೇದ ವೇದಾಂತ ಸಂವೇದ್ಯಂ ದೇವದೇವಿ.
Does not flow with the life, the wheel of life, destroy their life aimlessly, just in wandering aimlessly, ordinary sense pleasures. I tell you, becoming aimless, or even if you don't achieve anything, not bothering about it, is one of the worst crime. I have seen so many fellows, the so-called seekers, they will stop all their outer world activities, responsibilities, claiming they are going to achieve something in the inner world. They are also aimless wandering, aimless living. Bhagavan reminds you, taking accounts of inner space. What for you gave up all the outer world responsibilities? Are you getting to it? Are you achieving it? Are you working on it? Do you even have still that aim in your vision of your day-to-day life? Is it still part of your inner space still? Caught in the pattern of politics and dirty dumbness. Dumbness has 2 categories. Little clean, ignorant dumbness, and cunning, dirty dumbness. Getting caught with these patterns, you lose very aim of life, losing the very aim of life, becoming aimless. Just look back and realign the sincerity with which you started your spiritual journey, the intensity with which you started your spiritual purpose, the intensity with which life itself is began in you, the conscious life was initiated in you, look at it. It is sad, really, really sad. Even the so-called educated people miss the true aim of life from their inner space, getting caught with a social politicking, getting caught with the wrong patterns, losing honesty, becoming disintegrated and dishonest. Bhagavan beautifully says, see, wheel of life means constantly raising your frequency. Even if you miss one chance for raising your frequency, even if you miss one chance for raising your frequency, taking a wrong decision, missing the spiritual functioning, don't think that one is too small. No, that will become pattern in you. That is why Ramakrishna says, one slip is enough for you to be in the valley. It's like a snowballing effect. The Aghoris, actually, I am reading some of the texts on Aghori tradition. They say once, if an Aghori fails in one vow, they take totally 7 vow during the Aghori initiation. If he fails in one vow only once, over, he is no more Aghori. In this birth, he cannot be Aghori. I thought, this is too serious, too ruthless. That's the exact word I thought in my mind. What is this? Only once, failing in only one vow, you just throw him out of the whole sampradaya. This wandering aimlessly becomes a pattern, lifestyle. Ignorance becomes living trend. And the scary part in this whole thing is they have the titles, big words they know, call themselves as seekers, living enlightened beings. With that cozy words, they take care that the truth never hits them. They don't wake up to the fact they lost the original aim, ultimate aim in their life.
ಕಲ್ಪತರು ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮದಲ್ಲಿ ಕುಂಡಲಿನಿ ಜಾಗೃತಿಯ ಶಕ್ತಿಯನ್ನು ಕಂಡುಕೊಳ್ಳಿ. ಕುಂಡಲಿನಿ ಎಂದರೇನು? ಪ್ರತಿಯೊಬ್ಬ ಮನುಷ್ಯನಲ್ಲೂ ಸುಪ್ತವಾಗಿ ಅಡಗಿರುವ ಅಸಾಧಾರಣ ಸಾಮರ್ಥ್ಯವೇ ಕುಂಡಲಿನಿ ಶಕ್ತಿ. ಒಬ್ಬ ಜ್ಞಾನ ಗುರುಗಳ ದೀಕ್ಷೆಯಿಂದ ಈ ಕುಂಡಲಿನಿ ಶಕ್ತಿಯನ್ನು ಜಾಗೃತಗೊಳಿಸಬಹುದು. ಒಮ್ಮೆ ಕುಂಡಲಿನಿ ಶಕ್ತಿ ಜಾಗೃತಗೊಂಡರೆ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಜೀವನದ ಪ್ರತಿ ಕ್ಷೇತ್ರಗಳಲ್ಲೂ ಪರಿವರ್ತನೆ ತರುವ ಶಕ್ತಿ ಅದಕ್ಕಿದೆ. ಹಾಗೂ ಅದು ನಿಮಗೆ ಆರೋಗ್ಯ, ಸಂಪತ್ತು, ಯಶಸ್ಸು, ಸಂತೋಷ ಭರಿತ ಸಂಬಂಧಗಳು ಮತ್ತು ಆಧ್ಯಾತ್ಮಿಕ ಜ್ಞಾನೋದಯವನ್ನು ತಂದುಕೊಡುತ್ತದೆ. ಧ್ಯಾನ ಹಾಗೂ ದೀಕ್ಷೆಗಳ ಶಕ್ತಿಯ ಬಳಕೆಯನ್ನು ಕಂಡುಕೊಳ್ಳಿ. ಕುಂಡಲಿನಿ ಜಾಗೃತಿಯ ಒಂದು ಇಣುಕು ನೋಟವನ್ನು ಕಲ್ಪತರು ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮದಲ್ಲಿ ಅನುಭವಿಸಿ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಭವಿಷ್ಯವನ್ನು ರೂಪಿಸಿಕೊಳ್ಳಿ. ಪ್ರತಿ ವಾರಾಂತ್ಯದಲ್ಲಿ ಸ್ಥಳ ನಿತ್ಯಾನಂದ ಧ್ಯಾನಪೀಠ, ನಿತ್ಯಾನಂದ ನಗರ, ಬಿಡದಿ, ಬೆಂಗಳೂರು.
I know the aim and I have achieved it. Now I am telling you, if you are missing your aim, you are the loser in this whole leela of life. Missing the aim is an unforgivable mistake, unforgivable crime. The punishment for this is a life sentence for lives after lives after lives. The foolish mind, whenever they wanted to lose the aim of life, or whenever they want to justify their action, they try to compare themselves with my action. I have achieved the aim of life. I have nothing more to achieve. So don't compare with my action and plan your actions. Aimless living. You creating suffering for you and you creating suffering for others becomes inevitable when you are aimlessly living and when you lost your original goal, the original ultimate aim of life, who doesn't flow with the wheel of life. Understand, any part which has not become wheel but still stuck with the wheel is an obstacle. If you are not a part of the solution, you are the problem. If you are not part of the solution, be very clear, you are the problem. If you are not part of the administration, you are the problem. If you are not part of the aim, the ultimate goal, you are the cancer. Becoming honest, breaking the pattern of laziness, and breaking the pattern of aimlessly living. Just years are passing, being aimless, constantly measuring yourself, even though you have become immeasurable. Don't be delighted in the sense pleasures and lead aimless life. Follow the wheel of life. Wheel of life means raising your consciousness continuously. Continuously bringing tyaga into you. Stop comparing yourself with others and creating your identity. You are individual, unique. Continuously bring yourself to the peak of the best things you carry, best qualities you carry. Continuously raise yourself to the peak of the best qualities you have. Radiate them. Continuously raise them. Continuously raise yourself to the highest frequency. Take every chance to become more and more alive, more and more energetic, more and more intense, more and more radiating. Take every chance, every moment. Every moment, make bigger and bigger decisions. I mean, the decisions which you think you can't take because of your wrong pattern in the inner space. Take the decision. I tell you, human beings by nature settle down on panic pattern. Panic pattern is the base material out of which human mind is made. Even if you don't remember your aim, you automatically settle down on panic pattern. Don't think if you are not doing any sadhana, you are going to be standing in the same level where you left yourself. No. You will settle down on panic pattern. Ramakrishna says very beautifully, till the pot becomes gold, it has to be washed every day. As long as it is a copper, it has to be polished every day. So till the ultimate goal is achieved, you are bound to settle down every night in panic pattern. When you try to hide that panic pattern, you create one more layer called dirty dumbness. They go to doctor and hide the disease they have because they have a prestige problem to reveal the problem to doctor. No, really. They come to master and try to live around, have a spiritual life, have initiation, but can't express the problem with which they are suffering, can't express that pattern. Open it and get it cured, healed, cleared. Don't miss a single chance to raise yourself to the tyaga. Don't miss a single chance to raise yourself to vairagya. Don't miss a single chance to raise yourself to the Atmanjnana. Don't miss a single chance to raise yourself to the ultimate goal of life. If you want to know whether you are missing the goal or not, I'll give you a simple scale. Now, whatever I am saying, if you feel grateful, oh God, I have somebody to remind me constantly that I am missing, I should be aligning myself, I am grateful to him. If you have that feeling, you are going to align yourself, you are going to raise yourself. Rama had an astra, he will raise it and it will go and stand on the top and shower astras on every demon, and every demon will be attacked. Every demon thinks Rama is fighting with them. Actually, Rama is fighting with them. If you are irritated, then be very clear. You are leading an aimless life. Align yourself. Whether it is your day-to-day routine or way your mind functions, way your consciousness thinks, way you feel about yourself, don't settle on the panic pattern and try to protect that panic pattern by the dirty dumbness. You are protecting dirty dumbness with panic pattern. Or with panic pattern, dirty dumbness with panic pattern, you protect your panic pattern with dirty dumbness. Each one serves the other. Get out of this panic pattern and dirty dumbness. Delight in aim of life, the ultimate goal of life, the ultimate truth of life. Constantly, consciously, raise your frequency. Constantly, every moment, try to be in an enlightened space. If it is not happening, then clear. Bring clarity. Bring honesty. Bring integrity. Bring truthfulness. Align yourself. From the basic truth, start building. Catch the true ultimate aim of life. Align yourself to the wheel of life.
ಓರ್ವ ಅವತಾರ ಪುರುಷರಿಂದ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಜೀವನಕ್ಕೆ ದಿವ್ಯ ಮಾರ್ಗದರ್ಶನ ನೇರವಾಗಿ ಬೇಕೇನು? ಪ್ರಸ್ತುತಪಡಿಸುತ್ತಿದ್ದೇವೆ ಕರೆ ಮಾಡಿ ಪರಮಹಂಸರೊಡನೆ ಮುಖಾಮುಖಿ.
ನಿತ್ಯಾನಂದಂ ನಿತ್ಯಾನಂದ ಹಿಯರ್.
ಇಡೀ ಜಗತ್ತಿಗೆ ಪರಮಹಂಸ ನಿತ್ಯಾನಂದರು ಮತ್ತೊಂದು ಅಪೂರ್ವವಾದ ಹಾಗೂ ಅಸದೃಶವಾದ ಉಡುಗೊರೆಯನ್ನು ನೀಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ.
ಯು ಗಾಟ್ ಪ್ರಾಕ್ಟಿಕಲಿ ಎವ್ರಿಥಿಂಗ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಟೂ ಮಚ್ ಫಾರ್ ಅ ಫೋನ್ ಕಾಲ್.
ಪ್ರತಿದಿನ ಬೆಳಿಗ್ಗೆ ನಡೆಯುವ ಸತ್ಸಂಗದ ಸಮಯದಲ್ಲಿ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಎಲ್ಲಾ ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆಗಳಿಗೂ ನೇರವಾಗಿ ಉತ್ತರ ನೀಡಲು ಅವರು ಲಭ್ಯವಿರುವರು.
Now you ask anything you want in your life. Ask me any boon you want.
ಬೆಳಿಗ್ಗೆ 8 ಗಂಟೆಯ ನಂತರ +9180272799999 ಗೆ ಕರೆ ಮಾಡಿ ಸ್ವಾಮೀಜಿಯವರೊಂದಿಗೆ ಮಾತನಾಡುವ ಅದೃಷ್ಟ ನಿಮ್ಮದಾಗಿಸಿಕೊಳ್ಳಿ. ಹಾಗೂ ntv.nityananda.org ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇದರ ನೇರ ಪ್ರಸಾರವನ್ನು ವೀಕ್ಷಿಸಿ.
Greatest liberation in the life is liberation from others' words. Our scripture says the first step for yoga is controlling the words. Always people have interpreted this, controlling your words. I give you the right understanding, the sacred secret in this sutra. The first step for yoga is not just controlling your words, controlling that others' words don't affect you. The uttered words does not penetrate you and disturb you. Through this verse, Bhagavan is conveying two things. One, where Arjuna is caught. Arjuna is caught in certain sanskaras, engrams. Bhagavan is showing to Arjuna exactly where he is caught. Bhagavan says, the world will narrate your ill fame. Katayishyanti. The cheapest fear a man can have is the fear of others' words. I wanted to tell you, so I tell you, don't be afraid of people talking about you. Fellows who go on talking can't do anything. Fellows who can do something will not be talking. Small story. A woman was letting her husband have it with just a touch of more venom than usual. She was shouting, "You are an idiot. You have always been an idiot. You will always be an idiot. If they had an idiot contest, you would come in second." The guy was shocked. He is asking, "Why would I come in second?" asks the husband. Wife replies, "Because you are an idiot." Do not bother about what people talk. People who go on passing opinion cannot achieve anything, cannot do anything. People who have capacity to do does not waste their time in passing opinion. Bhagavan says, people will talk. If you are afraid of others' words, that is much worse than this fear. You not uttering word, you reducing your words, and others' words not affecting you. Standing with your clarity is life. I tell you, all the worst things happens to you by the decisions you make from letting others' words affect you. The worst thing can happen in your life is allowing this appraisal, briefing. This appraisal is the worst conspiracy. Listening to these briefings, appraisals and taking decision. You see, human mind is so weak, it does not believe its experience, but it believes what others vomit after they go through their half-baked experience. Biggest cancer, psychological cancer, all Indians are suffering, is kathayishyanti. Either you are suffering with the one part talking about others, or suffering with the other part, afraid of others' words. Both, these two are the largest cancer, largest disease with which Indians are suffering. I think we are suffering with this disease from the times of Mahabharata. That is why Bhagavan is talking about it in Gita. He knows not only people will be talking, he knows Arjuna is afraid of others talking. He goes to the extreme, dishonor is worse than death. With death, at least you are in completely new situation, new body and new people. But with the defaming, please understand, it's like crushing your personality but torturing you constantly by the same people. With the defamation, it's like your whole personality is shaken, your credibility is questioned. People who lived around you doesn't look at you in the same way they looked at you till yesterday. Everything is taken away, but you have to live in the same body, same mind, with the same people and same situation. Defamation is worse than death. But I tell you, just because of that, don't change your principles. Stand by it or intensify it. Either if you can intensify your principles after defamation, if you can't, at least stand by it.
It has 2000 crore loss.
Thank you. expected to reach at least 1 lakh people per day.